I'm Jessica Lombard, Associate Superintendent.
And I'm Superintendent John Berkey. And this is Huntley 158 Today. Well, today, Ms. Lombard, we are going to be talking about our medical academy at Huntley High School, which actually started about 5 years ago and is a separate academy that kids actually apply and interview to get into that helps prepare them for medical fields in the future.
The last few years I've been able to participate on the interview panel for that and am extremely proud of the students that we have coming through our school system and participating in this academy. Very impressive.
They're incredibly well prepared before they start the academy. I can only imagine what they're like once they graduate. But specifically today, we're going to be talking about one of the new aspects of the academy, and that's a senior year capstone, a residency program with the hospital that Centegra just opened. And Mrs. Dilorenzo is the teacher who's running this residency program this year. We'd like to welcome you and your students that are here today. But could you start off by telling us just a little bit about your background and how and why you became a science teacher, how long you've been in the district?
This is my 13th year in the district, and so I'm a biology person, and my area of like specialization has always been in the human body, and so I am actually pursuing a master's degree too, which has a lot of medically related classes in science too. And so I became involved with the medical academy when we took on the Project Lead the Way classes, and which has been a really good feeder to this program. So all of these kids have taken part in that as well.
So tell us about this residency program. What is it? What are the students actually going to be doing? And I know they've already started, but...
So it's an awesome, it's a capstone experience again for kids that have been inducted in the medical academy, and they can participate during their senior year. They can apply during their junior year to be a part of it. And the partners at Centegra have agreed to sort of mentor our kids, work side by side with them. And they have that unique opportunity to go and, you know, shadow them in their environments, so in a clinical setting, and kind of apply what they've seen throughout the last 3 years in their medical academy classes, and to be able to kind of pick their brains and you know, really see what it's like in the profession versus, you know, what they learn in a classroom.
So this isn't just a class that I sign up for. It's, as you say, a capstone class. There's a rigorous application process that they have to go through, a lot of time commitment for them. Can you kind of explain a little bit about that process?
Sure. To be a part of this, we have some, you know, minimums. Basically, we look in that selection process, we want kids that exemplify the Raider way, their core values. And so we want kids that in the medical academy in particular are respectful and responsible and involved. And so there is a minimum grade point average of a 3.5 to get into it. And then we ask for teacher recommendations so that we know that these are kids that are responsible, they're vested, and they're going to get the most out of it. And they've also, you know, put the most in. And so we get a good feel for their character. We want kids that are going to work well with the professionals in a professional manner in that setting. And so it's been really good so far. We've gotten really great feedback from Centegra about the job that the kids are doing, and the kids are coming back with great feedback about what they're seeing so far. So,
well, let's hear about some of those experiences you're having this year. Hunter, do you want to start? Russ, and tell us what you've done so far in the hospital and what you're getting out of it.
Mm-hmm. So basically there are three tracks, and the one that I started in is called specialty. So it's basically things that aren't in the hospital. They're in off-site places, so like the hyperbaric wound center, which is near my house, and also the gym right across the street from the hospital. And so basically every Tuesday and Thursday, there's a couple different time slots. It's awesome because I'm pretty busy, but I haven't had a problem with scheduling. And so basically you just go there for 2 hours. They're happy to have you. It's awesome. And you can ask questions, they're happy to answer. And you stay there, they give you, they fill out evaluation, make sure that you act professionally, and that's pretty awesome.
So what do you want to do for a career? Something in the medical field?
That's what I'm hoping this exposes me to, because basically going into this, it's reinforced what I've wanted to do, but I haven't really picked out a career. And so we've only gone to like a couple different so far, but I'm hoping once I go to a few more, I pick. But right now I want to study human biology in college and go pre-med as of right now.
Zach, how about you? Tell us a little bit about the experience you've had so far and what do you see in your future?
Okay, so with the experience that I've had so far, it's been really awesome to go there and meet with actual medical professionals and be able to ask them questions. Part of this program is you have to do research beforehand, so then you're exposed to the different occupation that you probably haven't even heard of before you started this program. And when I'm there, I'm constantly asking them questions. And just when I think I can't think of anything else to ask them, like, what questions do you have for me? What can I show you? They're really willing to help expose you to everything in the medical field. And that's really what I appreciate, because kind of the opposite of Hunter, as of right now, I want to be an orthopedic surgeon.
Natalia, how about you?
Okay, well, the program is not what I was expecting when I started off. It was really eye-opening when I went in. Because like normally job shadows are awkward and you're just kind of watching, but here you get to go into the surgery. Like I was in the cath lab the other day and they let me go in and actually see how they did the procedure, where they went in and like all the scans, and it was so cool.
And what do you see in your future? Do you know what you'd like to study and what university or college you'd like to go to?
I want to go to Europe to school because I'm a citizen in Poland, so I would get it for free, and I want to go into the surgery field, I guess, is how you say it. And I don't know really what kind of surgery, but surgery.
Well, it's pretty clear that we have some incredibly well-prepared students. I think it's great that they're getting this experience, which is really an experience that people are just not getting in high school at all. And so that's awesome. And I want to thank all of you and Mrs. DiLorenzo. I really want to thank you for everything you've done to help get this residency program going. It's clearly having a large impact on our students.
And thank you for joining us at Huntley 158 today. If you have questions you'd like seen answered here on our show or topics you'd like discussed, please reach out to us at our District 158 Facebook page or Twitter, hashtag Ask158. Until next time.